Good evening. Thank you for joining me tonight. I'm Bill Betlay, lay leader at Calvary United Methodist Church in Stuart Straff, Virginia. And we are back with another season of Tuesday night Vespers together. And we are harvesting the fruit. Our Vesper series is focusing on the fruit of the Spirit. Each Tuesday evening, we reflect and examine a specific fruit that is grown from our being filled with the Holy Spirit. Vespers, or evening prayer, simply allows us to pause and give thanks for the day that has just passed, and also make an evening sacrifice of praise to God. Each week, we'll begin with a short prayer followed by Scripture, and I hope you will join me in the responses which will appear in bold on your screen. Mary Jo Ramsey Smith, who is our worship music leader during this series, will then lead us in a song. And that'll be followed with a short reflection for you to consider your everyday walk with God. Our guest tonight will be Pastor David Vaughan. I'll then wrap up and we will end with our good night prayer together. I hope you will feel relaxed and thankful and be ready to start your nighttime rest. Tonight, our fruit is gentleness. Let's begin. Come, Holy Spirit, fill us. Come, Holy Breath, live in us. Come, Holy Wind, move through us and cause the fruit of your Spirit to ripen in our lives. Our responsive scripture reading for tonight is from Psalm 18, verses 31 through 36. Join me in the responses in bold on your screen. For who is God but the Lord? And who is a rock except our God? The God who equipped me with strength and made my way blameless. He made my feet like the feet of a deer and set me secure on the heights. He trains my hands for war so that my arms can bend a bow of bronze. You have given me the shield of your salvation, and your right hand supported me. And your gentleness made me great. You gave a wide place for my steps under me, and my feet did not slip. I must admit, I had never heard our song for tonight until Mary Jo recorded it. It's called Spirit, Spirit of Gentleness, and it's in the Faith We Sing. It's number 2120. Join Mary Jo as she leads us.
Spirit of rest. restlessness, stir me from placidness, wind, wind on the sea. You swept through and you goaded your people with the law and the land. And when you were blinded with their idols and lies, then you spoke through your prophets to open them. Gentleness, blow through the wilderness, calling and free. Spirit, spirit of restlessness, stir me from placidness, wind, wind on the sea. You say, whispered in silence when the whole world was still. And down in the city you called once again when you blew through your people on the rush of the gentleness, blow through the wilderness, calling and free. Spirit, spirit of restlessness, stir me from placidness, wind, wind on the sea. Bondage of sorrow, the captive dreams, dreams. Our women see visions, our men clear their eyes with bold new decisions. Your people are
the Bible speaks quite a bit about gentleness through stories, proverbs, and wisdom. Tonight's scripture comes from Paul's letter to the Ephesians, Ephesians chapter 4, verses 1 and 2. I urge you to live a life worthy of the calling you have received. Be completely humble and gentle. Be patient, bearing with one another in love. Gentleness may be one of the most important character qualities we need. So much of the peace and harmony we seek is directly affected by how we treat others. Our guest tonight is the lead pastor at Calvary United Methodist Church in Stewart's Draft, Pastor David Vaughan. Let's listen to Pastor David.
When I was a young man and a very new Christian, Galatians 5 was one of the very first passages of Scripture that I learned. And of course, I picked it up from a song. As I recall, the lyrics said this, "The fruit of the Spirit's not a kiwi. The fruit of the Spirit's not a kiwi. If you want to be a kiwi, you might as well hear it. You can't be a fruit of the Spirit. Because the fruit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. And then, of course, it goes on and on and on, as children's camp songs tend to do. I must have sung that song and read that verse 1,000 times over the years, but still, it stops me in my tracks. Every time I get to that next to last fruit in the list, I mean, love and joy and peace, sure, everybody can agree on that. Even patience and kindness and goodness, you can see the power of that kind of witness to the world. But gentleness? Does he know what he's saying here? How dangerous it is to tell God's people to respond to a world of hostility and violence with gentleness? If we take this seriously, we'll surely be taken advantage of. We'll find ourselves misunderstood and mistreated, beaten up and kicked around. We'll become doormats that people walk all over. And then where will that leave us? Except right with Jesus, who was misunderstood and mistreated all the time because people thought that he was too gentle. How many times in the Gospels do people come to Jesus wanting him to condemn someone because of the circumstances of their birth or the details of their life? How often did people demand that Jesus use his authority to put others in their place when they believed the wrong thing or behaved in the wrong way? And yet, whether it was a Samaritan woman at Jacob's well, or a tax collector up in a sycamore tree, or an unnamed woman caught in adultery, or a fearful Pharisee whispering in the middle of the night, Jesus was always more gentle with them than anyone else was. He lifted Peter out of the water when his faith had failed him. He told everyone to cut Mary some slack when they criticized her for pouring expensive perfume on his feet. He washed the feet of a friend he knew was about to betray him. And best of all, Jesus is gentle with us. When it feels like the whole world is judging us by the way we look, or the stuff we own, or the amount of work we get done, or the picture-perfect family we think we're supposed to have, Jesus sees something else, something more. He knows that life is hard, that a lot of days just don't go the way we planned. He knows that we all need some grace. If we're to follow him in this world, if we're to live like him every day, then we've got to extend the same grace to others that we've discovered for ourselves. And that starts with the spiritual fruit of gentleness. When we embody this fruit, we stop insisting on our own way all the time. We don't have to prove every point or win every argument anymore. We allow space for people to breathe and think and grow and change. We practice forgiveness. We believe in the future. We live in love. Maybe that's why the Spirit always stops me when I get to this place in the list. Maybe it's not that gentleness is so different or out of place from the other fruit. Maybe it's just the one that I need the most in order for everything else to make sense and come together. not long after I learned Galatians 5 from that Fruit of the Spirit song, I had the chance to begin volunteering at a place called Camp Rainbow. Camp Rainbow is a ministry of the Virginia Conference of the United Methodist Church that provides a week-long summer camp experience for adults with intellectual disabilities. It's a beautiful, almost magical kind of place where for a week, everything is about these campers. They sing songs and learn Bible stories and perform comedy sketches and create wonderful works of art all together. One night, they get all dressed up for a dance, and another night, they share their gifts in a blowout talent show that'll knock your socks right off. At Camp Rainbow, each camper is paired with a volunteer staff person who is their buddy for the week. And can I tell you that as a 16-year-old, it was the most humbling and terrifying and inspiring thing I'd ever done. To help my buddy shave in the morning and to make sure he got his nap in the afternoon and his medicine at night, to help him process everything that was going on around us, and to ensure that this was the best week of the year for him. It wasn't uncommon, after camp ended, to get cards and letters all year long from your buddy, with updates on what they were doing, and with the joyful excitement about the next time you'd be together. I know that it's kind of a cliche thing to say, but it really was true that if you were paying attention, you found that you learned and received a lot more from each camper than you ever gave to them as a volunteer. Camp Rainbow was my crash course in gentleness, my firsthand introduction to how life-changing this fruit of the Spirit can be. What's yours? What are the places in your life where a kind word and a little understanding could go a long way? Who needs you to see them and love them just as they are, as God created them to be? Who will be blessed if you share with them the kind of grace that you have received? The fruit of the Spirit's not a kiwi. It's the gentleness of our Savior revealed in us. Amen.
Growing in the fruit of the Spirit is expected in a child of God. As we grow, we develop our witness to others, what the faith and life of a Christian looks like. So I challenge you to make every effort on a daily basis to serve Jesus and others. Live by the fruit of the Spirit. Allow the Holy Spirit to lead you in your daily walk. Walk with Jesus, not the world, and rejoice in the harvest in the end. Join me now for our goodnight prayer. Our prayer is the same for each Vesper service so that you might become familiar with it and allow it to grow within you. Let us pray together. God, we ask that the fruit of your Spirit may grow in us. The fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Against such things there is no law. As we would grow with you, may we bring forth fruit that is pleasing to you. As we take our rest tonight, forgive us for the ways we have fallen short and strengthen us to do better when we wake. Amen. Thank you for joining us this evening. We'll be back here next week on the Calvary UMC Facebook and YouTube pages on Tuesday evening at 7:30, and we hope you will join us then. Good night. Thank you.
joy.